Welcome to Animals Wow TV. Today, we'll look at how the 5 worst alligator attacks happened in Florida. Stay until the end. You won't believe what happened to the alligator's victim. Number 5. The Disney Resort Alligator Attack, 2016. For many children, Disneyland is the epitome of fun. It certainly started that way for 2-year-old Lane Graves and his family. They were on vacation at Disney's Grand Floridian Resort in 2016. But then, tragedy struck. Lane was building a sandcastle near a lagoon in the resort when he bent over the edge of the water. Quick as a flash, an alligator came head first, snatched the toddler by his head, and turned back to the water. The boy's father attempted to save his son by grabbing the alligator's mouth and pulling his son, but the alligator struggled, broke loose, and dived into the water with the boy in its jaws. A search was immediately conducted. 6 alligators were captured and killed, but no reports showed that any of these were the attacker. Divers found the body 7 feet under the lagoon's water the following day. It had injuries to the head and the neck. The Orange County Sheriff's Office ruled the death as an accident. Another report said Lane did not provoke the alligator and that the death could be classified as a predatory attack. Reports later revealed that guests had been warned that an alligator was lurking in the lagoon. After Lane's death, Disney World limited possible visitor contact with alligators on the property. Number 4. The Silver Lakes Rotary Park Alligator Attack, 2018. South Florida has nature preserves that contain many different animals. It is this paradise-like quality that attracted Japanese Shizuka Matsuki to live in Plantation. Shizuka loved Florida's animals. During cold snaps, she would take care of iguanas that fell from trees and keep them under heat lamps until morning. She joined turtle rescues and birdwatching activities. She also had 3 rescue dogs that she usually walked along Davies Wolf Lake Park. Ironically, it was because of this routine that Shizuka met her savage death. On June 8, 2018, the Wolf Lake Park was closed, so Shizuka took her dogs to Silver Lakes Rotary Park. This second park's lake already had reports of alligator activity. A few days before Shizuka's routine walk in this park with her dogs, an alligator had wandered through their neighborhood. Yukio Matsuki, Shizuka's husband, viewed this as an omen, and his fears came true. Shizuka and 2 of her dogs never returned from the walk alive. Shizuka's body was later discovered in the park's water with bite marks from a 12-foot, 6-inch alligator. Are you learning a lot from this video? Then please take a moment to like and subscribe to our channel. Remember to hit the notification button for regular updates of our informative animal videos. Number 3. The Lake Cannon Alligator Attack, 2001. Florida has about 1.3 million alligators, so residents of the state have learned to adapt to living with these animals. Although attacks are not frequent, there are freak accidents that bring grief to families. But 2-year-old Alexandria Murphy's family had just transferred to a new neighborhood. They may not have known the dangers of Florida yet. Plus, the family's neighbors shared that they sometimes found Allie wandering through the neighborhood and into neighboring yards while unsupervised. One Saturday morning, she wandered from her home down the block and near Lake Cannon, where a 6.5-foot alligator snatched her and brought her into the water. The child's body was discovered an hour after Allie's mother and grandmother reported the toddler missing. Officers found her mangled body lying next to an alligator with hair in its mouth. It had multiple bites on the face and upper part and several broken bones. But the cause of death was confirmed as drowning. The alligator was caught and killed. Wildlife officials of the area said that the animals don't fear humans anymore because people have been feeding them. So, the alligator may have considered the little child as food. Number 2. The Sunrise Alligator Attack, 2006. Although Florida is swarming with alligators, you wouldn't really expect a jogger in a suburban neighborhood to be attacked and killed by this animal. But a 28-year-old biology student, Yovi Suarez Jimenez, died from such an incident. One Tuesday evening, Yovi left for a jog. Her relatives became concerned when she did not return to her mobile home park in Sunrise. Building workers discovered her body the following day. No one witnessed the accident. But based on the autopsy, a 10-foot-long alligator amputated Yovi's arms, bit her on the leg, and then dragged her into the water. Experts concluded that she was already dead by the time she was pulled into the water. Wildlife officers hunted alligators in the canal area to capture and euthanize the killer alligator. Number 1. The Lake Serenity Alligator Attack, 1993. 70-year-old Grace Eberhardt always liked to walk to the 4-acre Lake Serenity of the Continental Country Club, a retiree community. She would often spend her mornings sitting on a bench by the lake while reading a book. One Sunday, she went to the lake early in the morning. No one saw or heard anything until a man on his porch saw a body floating across the lake, with 3 alligators playing tug-of-war with it. The man called security guards, who, in turn, called wildlife officers. They discovered that the body had a broken neck and several parts bitten off. The officers shot 4 alligators and slit their bellies in search of the missing body parts. The largest, 9.5-foot gator stomach, contained parts of Grace's hand and arms. The other alligators had sticks, rocks, snail shells, and nuts in their stomachs, which told the officers that the animals were starving. Residents said the alligators were commonly seen in the area, but these usually stayed at the north side of the canal. Grace's son shared that his mother had cancer, but remained a sweet person. He also tried to spare his ailing father from the harsh truth of his mother's death. He'd only told his father that his mother had drowned. Grace was the 15th victim of an unprovoked alligator attack in Florida that year. Wildlife officers said that the increasing population of both humans and alligators meant more and more contact between the two. Some people even fed alligators. Still, experts advised staying away from ponds and swamps after dark and during dusk. There you have it, how the 5 worst alligator attacks happened in Florida. Do you have an alligator incident you'd like to add to the list? Share your thoughts in the comment section below. And don't forget to click the like button and to subscribe to our channel. And while you're here, you might want to check out our video of the top 10 deadliest animals in the world.